Take, for example, Tupac's advocacy of thug life. Thug life was slight of a misnomer as it conveyed a message that contradicted its perceived meaning. Thug life was not intended to encourage thug behavior, yet it was meant to reach the underserved, overlooked, disenfranchised individuals partaking in thug activities. Yet with all intentions, we as people are liable to fall short of them. And to a degree, I feel as though Tupac fell short of his intentions with thug life, not solely on the basis of his doings, but also the interpretations of others. And if you are someone that favors Tupac musically, you have listened to all of his songs, you have listened to all of his minor projects with, you know, groups that he was creating like the Outlaws. You know, if you've reviewed Tupac's resume as I have, you are able to note that there was a drastic shift within his persona once he transitioned to the West Coast. And if you are unfamiliar with the West Coast during the early 90s to mid 90s, you would just know, or I would inform you that it was not the best coast in terms of public safety. Furthermore, being the reason why N.W.A was put on a pedestal and Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg were very prominent, especially during the 90s, but even more so in the 80s, because they shed light on a culture, the violence and the disparity of the Black community, or a sector of the Black community during that time. So I feel like when Tupac went over to the West Coast, and this is a very subjective statement, this is my opinion as a fan, I feel like Tupac just really transitioned, not for the worse, yet not for the better. So I say all this to say, it seemed as if Tupac's death was to be expected as it was unexpected. Even as historians and favoring audiences analyze the lyrical content of his music, or observe various events within his life prior to his death, it seemed as if Tupac himself could foresee what was to be foreshadowed. So I exemplify Tupac Shakur's life, passing, and legacy to furthermore place emphasis on how within life at times we feel as if it is so unpredictable, yet within various aspects of it, it is quite predictable. I don't know exactly what's going to come tomorrow, but I could foresee what is to be foreshadowed. In the same way that Tupac was able to sense this ever looming, you know, agony that existed over his life, maybe the entirety or for a portion of his life, there seemed to be a very low vibrational, very low frequency type of energy just surrounding his being in that moment in time. And it seemed as if he was able to foresee, like, I don't know who's going to take me out, but I know somebody might take me out. You know, after being shot 5 times and I'm still breathing, there's a proof of a gun, you need a reason. You know, after he got shot 5 times and he was still breathing, there's a proof, there's a God if you need a reason. You know, after he got shot 5 times, he could probably foresee within the future, like, dang, like, if I keep on doing what I'm doing, or if these people that did what they did to me are still out, I could very well die. You know, he didn't know who was going to kill him. He didn't know how he was going to die, like I said. But there's certain things within your life that you can look towards, that you can look to understand the preceding actions. But it's like, you got to be careful. You got to be careful with what you say. You got to be careful with what you do. You want to ensure that your mind is also in accordance with your body, and or vice versa.